Hi, everybody. Reese Davis with you, bringing you the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 pregame show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. The Tigers have not only put together a nice winning streak, they're starting to play at a much higher level, and they've energized their entire campus. Now the question is, will they be able to handle everybody on campus, patting them on the back, telling them how good they are, and telling them how they expect a big win in this one? Thanks for checking out the pregame show. NCAA college football action coming up next with Brad and Kirk on the call. David and I will see you at halftime.
Jordan-Hare Stadium, the sixth largest on-campus stadium in the entire country, the site for this college football showdown. And now it's time for the coin toss, and it's brought to you by Coke Zero. Real Coca-Cola taste, zero calories. Enjoy everything. The pregame festivities are over, and we're just about set to get this game underway. Nice kick, plenty of distance. He's to the 20. Tackle made at the 26-yard line. So let's see what the offense can do as they come out onto the field. Got his man. Can't tack on any yardage. It's second down and four to go. Ball on the 32. Tackle at the 35. Decent pickup. Good run by the quarterback.
The thing that impresses me is the decision making. He sees it opening, decides to turn it upfield, and gets a nice gain and a first down.
From their own 39-yard line. First down. And they get nice yardage on that run. Ole Miss has got a guy that statistically is leading the conference right now, and he has got the attention of everybody in the country, including the coordinators. He's on the run, and they make the stop around the 44-yard line. Third and five coming up. Ball on their own 44. And they get the sack.
I think this defensive end is doing a great job of getting after the quarterback. Not only the sack in this case, but it seems like the entire game he's done a good job of creating pressure, making this quarterback feel in, and almost giving him happy feedback there. He doesn't seem to be in rhythm and almost seems to be throwing the football, feeling the pressure and almost creating nerves on the quarterback.
They're coming after this punter. Booming kick. This punt goes over the goal line, and this will be a touchback. The Tigers know that they can give this guy the ball, Kirk, 25, 30 times a game, and that's great. And if it's working, that's perfect. But also, as a defensive team, you look at him and you go, we worry about him too much, we could get burned somewhere else.
Well, the defensive coach has told us this week the first thing that they have to do is stop this running game. And when you're convinced that you have to stop the running game, you leave your defensive backs, especially your corners, isolated one-on-one in coverage. And if they're smart, they'll try to take advantage of that and try to make some big plays in the passing game, maybe early, and then go back to old reliable, and that's running the football.
From their own 22-yard line, second down. He delivers. Tackle made around the 37-yard line.
Not a real fancy play here, just a smartly run route. Good protection and a well-placed ball. Most times, you don't need much more than that.
Makes it out to about the 46. It's second down now. They're just a few feet away from that first down marker. He's taken down at the 45-yard line.
This passing game can be very effective if you don't get enough pressure on the quarterback. They use their personnel well and can be very tough to defend.
Looking to scramble down. He can't get away from the pressure. Defense looking for another sack here on this second and 13 situation. He ran a good looking route and picked up positive yardage.
That he did, and he made a good catch. That short passing game is where you see all those hours in the summer that you put in pay off.
Down, and they need to get it down to the 35. Now he tries to buy some time, and he's taken down at the 41. He might have gained a yard on that scramble. Auburn is looking to go up by three. It's up, looks long enough, and he missed it left. No good.
Well, sometimes when you see a kick like that, the kicker is trying to compensate for a factor, maybe like the wind, and he thinks he can hook it back in. Didn't happen that time.
They've got to play with some focus and smarts here. They don't want to make a mistake and suddenly find themselves trailing. In the shotgun and five wideouts. Caught, and he's hit immediately. So at the end of one, no score here. Set to resume action here in quarter number two. Deadlock after the first 15 minutes. Gets out to around the 48.
That's a nice job by the quarterback to pitch the ball, and it got him a first down.
From the 48-yard line, first down. He makes his way out to about the 35. Bring him down at about the 21. First down, 10 to go. Ball on the 21.
Three down. Four is one.
And two.
Orange three.
Brought down at the 13-yard line. He's tackled around the 2-yard line. It's first down.
They've got four cracks at it inside the five. It's first and goal.
They're crowding that line of scrimmage. Touchdown, Rebels.
That was a very good all-around effort. The running, the blocking, the entire package. A well-deserved score.
And he hits the PAT. So that's a seven-play, 59-yard drive. And a touchdown as a result. Ole Miss is lining up to kick this one off. He's to the 20. He's got the corner. He gets hit out of bounds at the 32.
There hasn't been too much daylight between these two teams. In games like this, some players try to press too much, and that can cause mistakes.
Here he goes. Makes it out to about the 43. First down, 10 yards to go. Ball on their own 43. Gets it out in a hurry. Almost picked off.
Brady drops the ball here. I don't know if he's starting to peek downfield and think about the return or what, but that ball's right in his hands. He just dropped it.
Gains his way to the 46-yard line. First and 10. Ball on the 46. And down he goes at the 43-yard line.
This offense right now has a ton of confidence because their offense seems to be in sync. Anytime you can run the football and mix in play action pass, it puts a lot of pressure on the defense. And right now, well, you can almost feel this offense's confidence growing, as we saw in that last play.
First and 10, ball on the 15. So the defense comes up with a fumble. Is that turnover going to hurt him?
Well, every turnover hurts, but hopefully for their sake, this running back will go out there next time and hold on to the football a little bit better.
So a big momentum shift could be in the making here as we take a look at the possible fumble. And the booth is going to take a few looks at this to see whether or not the ball came out before he was down. So the booth and the referee agree. The runner's knee was down.
That was still a close call, though, Brad. Even though he was down, this guy has to do a better job of holding that football.
Second down and 9 to go. Ball on the 14-yard line. Takes it up the middle for a nice run. Scrambling, decides to take it himself, and he's got it. Touchdown. They'll line up for the extra point in an attempt to tie the game. And he adds the extra point. A nice seven-play, 68-yard drive, and they come away with a touchdown.
Boy, this offense right now is just being physical, really controlling the line of scrimmage, and it's opening up some nice big lanes for the running backs.
Everyone's all lined up and ready for the kickoff. He sends this one deep. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback.
Both offenses have played it pretty close to the vest so far in this one.
Yeah, because they've been so conservative, it's made it pretty easy for both of these defenses to be pretty dominant. Let's see an offense open it up and take a few chances.
This is the point in the game where you don't want to make any mistakes that give the other guys a reason to feel more confident going into halftime. Throws quick to the receiver, and it falls incomplete. From their own 25-yard line, it's second down. He's going to try and scramble. Tackle at the 32-yard line. Incomplete.
Nothing clicking there. Let's see if they can make a few adjustments before their next series.
Shivers back deep to return. And this one is a beauty. He'll take it from the 18. He's taken down at the 33-yard line.
You always want to go in the locker room with momentum, so as we get closer to halftime, I think we'll see more and more attempts to create big plays.
And he's going to come up with a sack.
The protection broke down. The defense was in the backfield in a hurry, and they brought the quarterback down. Nice play.
Second and 15. Ball on their own 27. He shoved out of bounds right around the 36-yard line. Fires it out. And he tackles him hard at the 42. Jackson gained 6 yards with a short completion. The Rebels taking their first time out of the half. Chapman is waiting for the snap. He punts it away, and it's a great kick. This one will go into the end zone, and they'll bring it out to the 20. This is the point in the game where you don't want to make any mistakes that give the other guys a reason to feel more confident going into halftime. Slings it.
That's the kind of play calling and execution I like to see. Being one-dimensional on first down can really stack the odds against you. It's better to mix it up.
It's first and 10. Ball on the 33.
20. Go.
Now he's scrambling. That's a great tackle at the 28. We played a half of football. We're even at 7 in this one.
Glad to have you with us in the studio for the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 halftime show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. Reese Davis and David Pollack here completely.
All right, Reese and David, thanks, guys. Second half action just about ready to start here.
Shivers fields it at the 1. And he's tackled at the 25. Time's getting a little bit tighter now. You got to make every possession count. Looks left, finding his tailback. And they make the stop around the 34-yard line. Short yardage situation here. It's second down and one. Chucks it downfield. And a great catch downfield. Now it's first and 10 after the big pass play. For the sack. And this is the eighth play of the drive. They go to the back, and he's hit immediately in the backfield. And now they're faced with another third and long as they try to convert and move those chains again. Moves up in the pocket and down he goes. Auburn could take the lead with this field goal. Kicks away. And he just drilled it from long range. And he's got to be happy about that kick.
Oh, no question. This kid is just a solid kicker.
10-7, Auburn. He just drills this one. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. Auburn's the type of team, when you look at them, it looks like their defense sort of just feeds off itself.
I think the energy is there, Brad, but I think it really starts up front with their defensive line and their linebackers, the way they're being able to just win the battle at the line of scrimmage. I think it's giving them confidence, and it's allowing them to play more downhill when they can attack this offense.
Tackle made around the 37-yard line. We've got a first and 10. Ball on the 37.
Three down, three down. Watch two, watch two.
Here we go. Gets it. He's in space. He's taken down at about the 45. Woo! hand it off. He might have a chance. And he's taken down around the 43-yard line. First down, 10 to go. Ball on the 43. Scrambling around. Slides down to the ground.
Backwards plays can have a psychological impact. It can damage a team's confidence if it keeps happening.
Third down now, and they need to get it down to the 33. Halfback's got it on the quick throw. They'll bring him down at the 42-yard line. Taken back a yard.
They really just didn't have any room to work on that play. The defense just suffocated them there.
Ole Miss can tie it up here with this kick. It's up. No good. He pushed it to the right. Let's go to the studio for this Reese Davis update.
The Volunteers come into today's game ranked 25th and hoping a win will move them up in the rankings. And for Georgia, they scored through the air. Tennessee leads it 24-10.
And for the Rebels, they may not need any extra motivation, but if they know that score in that game, they know how big this game is. Auburn is up a field goal. Can't tack on any yardage. We head to the final quarter, and we've got a great game on our hands. 10-7, Tigers. Right, about set to start action here again in the fourth quarter. Down around the 47-yard line. From the 47-yard line, it's first down. And he's going to lose big yardage. He's tackled immediately after the catch. 5-yard loss on the play.
Well, that's just a sound play by the defense. They dropped him well short of the line of scrimmage.
From their own 48-yard line, it's second down. Now he tries to buy some time. He's tackled at the 45-yard line. Receiver. And down he goes at the 16. First and 10. Ball on the 16-yard line. Auburn has a 3-point lead. He's hit and taken down. First and goal from the 2. Let's see if they just don't try to power their way into the end zone here.
Distance. He had great blocking up front on that play.
He splits the uprights with the extra point. Time for an update from the studio. Reese, what have you got?
Let's get you up to date on everything going on in the top 25. We've been watching this thing all day long. And for Tennessee, a masterful game plan by their offensive coordinator. And for Warren, he snagged a couple of touchdown passes. The Volunteers have the lead, 34-10.
And for the Rebels, they don't want to lose any more ground. If that score holds up, they've got to win this football game. Nice kick, plenty of distance. Everyone's all lined up and ready for the kickoff. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. They'll take over here, ready to start a new series. Just under 3 to go in regulation. To that quickly. Tackle at the 39.
Roger, Roger. Mike 40, Mike 40. Green check, back, check. Back. Dancer, dancer.
Throws quickly and it's almost intercepted. From their own 39-yard line, it's second down. Takes it up the middle for a nice run. He's pushed out of bounds, the 48-yard line. The offense that takes the field on fourth down. They're trying to stop the run here with a goal line defense. On the run of the defense will hold.
I'm not sure the offense had much of a choice here. It was a pretty short conversion. The defense just made a good play.
Both teams are well aware that a score on this drive is going to create an almost insurmountable lead. This defense has really got to step it up and make a stop. And he's tackled right around the 34.
If you can consistently run effectively like this, it'll force the defense to pay more attention to the run. And that creates chances in the play-action passing game.
Tackle outside after a nice pickup. Shivers gains around 6 yards on the run. Ole Miss is going to have to use their second time out of the half. So it's second down now, and they need about 4 yards to pick up the first. Less than 2 minutes in the fourth quarter. Up the middle for a nice game. The Rebels using their third and final timeout. Fires it out. Big play there, and now they're looking at first and goal. First and goal from the 4. They're knocking on the door. Yardage on that run.
Check 3, check 3, check 3.
They're crowding that line of scrimmage. Quick throw in the end zone, touchdown. And he adds the extra point. Let's get the latest now from Reese Davis.
Let's check in on the SEC. Tennessee wins it 34-10. In another game, let's have a look at some scores from around the country. Several surprises today. And for Arkansas, they're trying to change their luck. We've got a 7-7 game.
Thanks, Reese. 24-7 in our game here. Carlson looks ready to kick this one off. Sends it sailing downfield. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. Nothing left here except to see the clock hit zero. A comeback is just not happening. Under a minute left in the game. He's going left. Second and 10. Ball on the 25. Hit immediately.
Kill, kill, kill.
Three. Switch, switch,
switch. Quick pass. The defense didn't stop the pass, but they stopped him short of the sticks.
And that's the important thing here. Allow him to make the catch, but make sure you tackle him before he gets to the first down marker.
Over. The Tigers come out on top, 24-7. That brings this broadcast to a close. For EA Sports and Kirk Herbstreit, I'm Brad Nessler. We'll see you soon for another edition of NCAA Football 14.